Hello, my name is David. I want to show you the measurement system ELMUS module. But at first, what is electroluminescence? Electroluminescence is an effect of semiconductors, so it describes the generation of light by electric stimulation. This effect appears, for example, in a LED. So to capture an electroluminescence image of a solar panel, you need, of course, a solar panel and a power supply. With this, you can send current through the panel. So all active zones start to emit infrared light. This light can be acquired with a special camera, and so the performance of all areas can be inspected. But now I can show this practically. At first, we have to insert the panel into the system. Then I have to connect the electrical contacts. Here the system allows to connect different adapter cables for several plug types. And now to the software. At first, I have to connect two cameras and the power supply. The system is delivered with two cameras, an overview camera and a detail camera. In the initialization step, the motor zoom lens is set to a reference position, so we have to wait for a moment. I check the technical parameters in the register user-defined settings. The software supports two types of image acquisition, the standard mode and the best quality mode. In the standard mode, the system will acquire a single image. In the best quality mode, the system will take a complete sequence and increase the image quality significantly. But of course, the best quality mode will take more time. The most important settings are the strength of the current and the shutter time. For this panel, I use 8 ampere. This is the short circuit current. But this depends on the panel type. The shutter time can be defined here. It defines the period of time in which the camera is sensitive to the light. In this example, I use a shutter time of 8000 milliseconds. That means the camera will acquire light for 8 seconds. If the image is too dark or too light, I can change this with this setting first. I don't change all other parameters. Now check the register info. It contains general information about the system, for example the sensor type, the resolution of the camera, the bit depth, and the version number of the camera firmware. Box system details contains information about the connected power supply. In the group box user interface, I can see the version number of the user software. So we are ready to capture an image. To do that, I go back to the register make control and activate the button measurement in the group box overview cam. Now I have to wait for a second. The left part of the window shows now the acquired overview image. To look at more details, I open the lab window. In this window, it is also possible to calculate a histogram and the image intensity of a selected area. I can see a dark area on this panel. This is definitely a defect. The system is available in two model types for the detail camera movement, a manual and an automatic version. In this version, I have to move the detail camera manually. In the automatic version, I have to make a double click on the interesting area. Now I check the acquisition parameters of the detail camera. For both cameras, the same settings are used. Additionally, I can change the field of view for the detail camera. In this example, I set the field of view to 240 × 180 mm. So the detail camera will capture a little bit more than one solar cell. Now I can start the image acquisition of the detail camera. Here we have the image of the detail camera. We can see a big crack starting at the bus bar. I want to save this image. So, I have everything I want and can disconnect the software. Please check the user manual for further information. Goodbye.